This short video is made to answer those who would call you racist or anti-Semitic. I have said before that the Talmud is the most racist book in the world. There is no bigger evidence of this than the curse of Ham. What the Talmud does is twist everything that was put in the Bible to comfort and tell us the truth and spins it on its head. Noah's three sons are where the nations came from, and what we consider the races of man. Shem, who became the Shemites, and the Arabs. And yes, the biblical Jews are Arabs. Abraham had two sons, Isaac and Ishmael. Add to that, Moses went to Arabia, the land of Midian, to find his wife. Mount Sinai has been found, and this fact is hidden from you. I will link you the video, and you can view it for yourself. It is right where the Bible said it would be, in Midian. The maps that are included with most Bibles are wrong. The sons of Japheth, which the Ashkenazi come from, are Caucasian, and this includes the Asian people. Hair type is the distinguishing factor. The Talmud took the account of Noah cursing Ham for not clothing him when he was drunk and naked in the Bible book of Genesis, and have made it some kind of magical curse, and as a reason that they should enslave and commit genocide on people with dark skin. The idea that Noah had some kind of magical powers to curse his son is ludicrous. If you look at all the shipping manifests of the slave trade, you will see Ashkenazi behind it, and people are now discovering this fact. This has led many people with African roots to say that they are the true Shemites, which is simply not possible. I don't blame them for thinking the idea of the curse of Shem is ridiculous. It is. But Jesus said in Luke 21:24 that the Jews would fall by the sword and will be taken as prisoners to all the nations. Jerusalem will be trampled on by the Gentiles until the times of the Gentiles are fulfilled. The only people that fulfill this prophecy is the Palestinians. The Talmudic interpretation of the curse of Ham is just one of many false and horrible teachings in the Talmud that allow its adherents to commit horrible acts for which they feel vindicated. Along with this, we have the Talmudic interpretation of King David. The Bible account of David was put there for a reason. It was to show us that no matter how far we sink into depravity, we can always come back if we ask forgiveness. The idea that you can sell your soul is wrong. Now, if you ask a Talmudic scholar or rabbi about King David, they will tell you that David had every right to kill Bathsheba's husband and that he did not sin. This is what the Talmud is all about. Self-worship and the idea that you can do anything you want, including murder. Now, for another thing, I have seen on just about every TV special on Jesus, these Judaic biblical scholars saying Jesus was not the Jewish Messiah because he failed. Your answer to this: the book of Isaiah, written 700 years before Jesus lived, chapter 52, verse 13 through chapter 53 is perhaps the two most important chapters of the Bible. It foretells that Jesus was coming here specifically to die for mankind. It tells us in chapter 53, verse 8, that he would have no descendants and then would be cut off from the living. So to anyone that says Jesus had children, sorry. The New Testament can be trusted. The Gnostic books of the Bible cannot be trusted. It was prophesied that he would have no children. Jesus has fulfilled all prophecy that he was supposed to up until now, and he will fulfill true Zion when he comes back. This is when his offspring is spoken of, and this can very well mean a symbolic offspring. The scepter of rulership has never passed from Judah, because Jesus now rules in heaven. Jesus abolished the priesthood of the Torah Jews. Jesus said in Matthew 23:8, but you are not to be called rabbi, for you have only one master and you are all brothers. And do not call anyone on earth father, for you have one father and he is in heaven. Nor are you to be called teacher, for you have one teacher, the Christ. Has there ever been a more clear-cut verse than this? Now, one more thing that they will likely use against Jesus and Christians. Jesus calls himself the bright morning star at the end of Revelation. I have already seen people saying Jesus is Satan. Again, the Bible provides the answer. When God is speaking to Job in chapter 38 and explaining the creation of the world, among other things, he says in verse 7, "While the morning stars sang together, and all the angels shouted for joy." The morning stars are simply high-ranking angels. Jesus is the bright morning star because he has been raised above them. In Hebrews chapter 1, verses 4 through 5, it says that Jesus became as much superior to the angels as the name he has inherited is superior to theirs. For to which of the angels did God ever say, "You are my son, today I have become your father"? Or again, "I will be his father and he will be my son"? Now those are the biggest things that I have seen misinterpreted, and those should be rebuttals. And they aren't my rebuttals. They are the Bible's rebuttals. Jesus was our only teacher and our only father is in heaven. Anything a father or rabbi says should be ignored completely. The Talmud is not to be trusted at all. I am not racist and do not hate anyone, but I do hate racist teachings like those found in the Talmud. We are all God's chosen people if we choose to be. In the Bible books of Acts, chapter 8, Philip baptizes an Ethiopian eunuch as soon as the man learns about Jesus and accepts Jesus as his Messiah. That was all that was required of him, and there was no curse of Ham to prevent it from being done.
Old pirates, yes, they rabbi, sold I to the merchant ships. Minutes after they took I from the bottomless pit, but my hand was made strong by the hand of the Almighty. We forward in this generation triumphantly. Won't you help to sing these songs of freedom? 'Cause all I ever have, redemption songs, redemption songs. Emancipate yourselves from mental slavery. None but ourselves can free our minds. Have no fear for atomic energy, 'cause none of them can stop the time. How long shall they kill our prophets while we stand aside and look? Some say it's just a part of it. We've got to fulfill the book. Won't you help to sing these songs of freedom? 'Cause all I ever have, redemption songs, redemption songs, redemption songs. Emancipate yourselves from mental slavery.